Hello friends, today we are going to discuss universal bevel protractor and general description of various component of universal bevel protractor. Now as you can see from this instrument, it has various component. Like we have body, working edge, then we have acute angle attachment, then we have this blade, then turret, slow motion device, scale is provided, that is main scale, and we also have the vernier scale, and the magnifying glass is provided to get the correct reading of the vernier scale. And this one over here is the blade locking nut. Okay, now why it is called as a bevel protractor? Because of this beveled edge. Now as you can see, this one, the beveled edge. Due to this beveled edge, it is called as universal bevel protractor. And universal means it can measure acute as well as obtuse angle. That's why it is called as universal bevel protractor. Now we will closely look how we are going to take the reading. Prior to that reading, we will just explain the function of each part. Like suppose this is body of the bevel protractor. It is designed in such a way that its back is flat. Now you can see the back of this bevel protractor is perfectly flat. You can see from this line. If that back is flat, then we can attach or we can move it on the surface plate. Okay, as well as we can lift out in the vertical position. Okay, so you can see there are no projection beyond its back. So that when the bevel protractor is placed on its back on the surface plate, there shall be no perceptible rock. Okay, the flatness of working edge of the stock, this flatness. The flatness of this working edge of the stock and body is tested by checking the squareness of the blade with respect to stock when blade is set at 90 degrees. Now what is the stock? You can say this is the stock. Now what is the main function of this stock? The working edge of the stock is about 90 mm in length and 7 mm thick. You can see this is the 7 mm thick. It is very essential that working edge of the stock should be perfectly straight. And if at all departure in the order of 0.01 mm maximum over the whole span. So 0.1 mm, 0.01 mm maximum over the whole span. The next instrument we have this blade. So it can move along the turret just by rotating this locking nut. We can move this blade. Okay, so it can move along the turret throughout its length. So this slot is provided to facilitate the locking. It is about 150 or 300 mm long. So this is the 150 mm long blade. And this one over here is a 300 mm long blade. You can see the bevel edge. Again, 3 mm wide and 2 mm thick. The ends bevel at 45 degree and 60 degree. So you can see this end is at 60 degree. You can able to, this is 60 degree and this end is 45 degree. Now as far as accuracy of this bevel protractor is concerned, as it is used for the angular measurement, we can give the accuracy in terms of minutes. So the main scale is in the degree and vernier scale will in combination will give us the least count in minutes. For the least count, we have the formula that smallest division on main scale, that is 1 degree, and you know 1 degree equals to 60 minutes. So 60 on the numerator and the denominator, we have 12 division on the vernier scale. Okay, so 12 division on the, in the denominator. So list count for this universal bevel protractor will be 5 minutes. Okay, now the working edge should be straight up to 0.02 mm and parallel up to 0.03 mm over the length of 300 mm. So this is 300 mm length. Over its length, it must be parallel to 0.03 and must be straight up to 0.02. It can be clamped again at any position. Okay, we can easily move this turret. So we can take it out and we can attach different blade. Again we can clamp. Okay, so the new set of blade is attached. Next we have acute angle attachment. It can be radially fitted into the body and clamp at any position. At any position we can easily clamp it from this clamping screw. Its working edge should be flat within 0.005 mm and parallel to the working edge of the stock. Okay, so working edge of the stock, it should be parallel within 0.015 mm over the entire length of the attachment. So this total bevel protractor is tested for flatness, squareness, parallelism, straightness and angular intervals by suitable method. Now what is the use of this bevel protractor? You can see the use of bevel protractor is to check inside bevel face of the ground surface. Second use bevel protractor for checking of V-block. Third use of vernier protractor or this bevel protractor for measuring of the acute angle. Okay, so this is our bevel protractor. So again we will have the closer look for the bevel protractor for its list count and angles. Okay, again we just take this blade out. Now if you can see the closer to this, whether it is visible or not. Okay, now you can see. Let me turn this flash off. Okay, now you can see there are vernier scale inside this glass. So the zero for the vernier scale. So this is zero for the vernier scale. Okay, and this one is main scale. Now to get the correct reading, we must have the closer look where that zero coincide. Okay, now you can see from this. Where that zero is, I think it is at 51, I guess. Yes, it is at 51. Then 51 is your main degree. Then we need to find out which line is coinciding. So after calculating this line, I can say third line is coinciding. So 15, 1 degree and 15 minutes. So 3 into 5 minutes will give you the correct reading. Now to set it at 90 degree, we just have to rotate this turret. And you can see it is set at 90 degree. So you can see from this here. Here we have set it at 90 degree. Okay, that means if I clamp now the blade to this locking nut, it will give you the 90 degree angle. Like in this manner. So you can see this angle over here is 90 degree angle, perfect 90 degree angle. Okay, so the same angle is visible on this scale. Okay, so 0, 90 degree. This concludes our practical for the universal bevel protractor and its demonstration of various parts. Thank you.